Huge news today when Softr announced that they now integrate with Notion, one of the most ubiquitous no-code tools out there. I'm gonna be real with you, I'm not sure if I'm excited about this or not, because honestly, I'm not much of a Notion lover. Notion is not a software that I like to use, and in fact, every time somebody makes me use it, I get pretty anxious. So, is this gonna be an integration I even enjoy? I don't know, but I've gotta talk about it, so if that's of interest, stick around, and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools, which means that you can build and streamline your own workflows and processes and save you a ton of time thanks to no-code. Now, in this video, as I said, we're going to be taking a look at the brand new integration between Softr and Notion. If you're not already familiar with these tools, Notion is typically more in the lines of a backend tool, a place to store information, although it does have some really unique and creative ways that it allows you to share that data, share that access in the form of what's almost like a wiki page. And then in addition to that, we've got Softr, which fills in this other need where we are able to build actual portals and web pages based on our data that lives in a data source, in this case, Notion. So we're gonna be taking a look at this, and of course I want to encourage you to follow along with me here. And if you're not already a paid Softr user, you can go ahead and sign up using our promo code that Softr's provided for us. Just follow the steps you see here on your screen to get access with that 1 month of a free pro account. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. As I said, follow along with me. We're gonna start in Notion. If you've never built up Notion before, well, you're in the perfect place because neither have I. So here you see I just logged into my Notion account and it's prompting me to join this AI thing, meet the AI tool, which I have not used. We can add a line and insert something. We can drag the button to reorder. Okay. I want to get right into creating and working with something here. It looks like I start off with a personal CRM, which is kind of interesting. So it's got some fake contacts that it's created here, some associates. Interesting. All right. It's giving me an example of what the typical Notion experience might look like. And of course, up here at the top, I can click through these different fields within my table. So Notion has the look and feel of many of the different database tools. As I mentioned, one of the key differences in Notion, though, is the way that it shares this information. It's basically on a page, and so we can, of course, share this with other people, but if we need those more advanced use cases, that's where we're going to need to rely on some sort of portal or interface builder. How do we create our own unique app running from the data that we have here? Well, that's what Softr is all about. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a few different tables of information inside of Notion, and then we're gonna map that information to Softr so that we can see how an actual portal comes together inside of Softr, integrated with Notion. So first we're gonna go up here and create a new page. Looks like I can add a table. Good, that's what I'm looking for. So I will just create a new table. Looks like we have that. I will name it, here we go. Figuring it out as we go. This will be, let's say, users. And it looks like I've got different automations, groups, all kinds of fun stuff attached to this. Cool. I've got my users. I can add a new table or I can change the views here. Looks like I can also add different fields, which comes in here. They're calling them properties, it looks like, inside of Notion. So, okay, I'll go with email. Almost every user table that you're going to need to build inside of Softr will have an email address as well as a name field. I don't need tags here though, so how would I delete these? Literally don't even know how to delete something. Remove. Remove altogether. Delete property. All right. Figured it out. So this is it for users. I've got my basic user information. I'm going to create my own self as a user here and I'll plug in my email address. Looks like my hotkeys don't work, so I will have to type it out the old-fashioned way. All right, there we go. I've got my first user now added. I can get rid of these two. And one other thing, another property or field, depending on what universe you come from in no code, you might want to also add a role. So they have this select field here, which I'm going to choose, and I'm going to call it role. And we're going to add some options now to these roles. So maybe I have managers and maybe I have contractors in my no-code app. Now, the reason for the role field when we add something like this into our Softr build is that we can actually put different levels of permissions in for our users. So we could say, in this case, this user, Gareth, maybe is a manager. And so we could set up different permissions, different visibility inside of our app for managers as compared to contractors. So we can pull this data into our Softr portal when we're putting together our application, and that's going to dictate how people navigate and interact with the tool. All right, we're going to build one more page here. So let's go ahead and do another page. And I don't know what I'm going to call this one. This will be projects, let's say. And we're going to put in another table. And again, I'm just going to keep this pretty high level. I'm going to have project name here. So this will be project 1, project 2, and project 3. And we have these different tags. I'm not sure what these are. Select an option or create one. This will be test tag. Now, rather than going into a lot of detail about how to build this stuff in Notion on the back end, what I really want to look at is how to integrate this now with that Softr portal. So the last thing I need to do before I move over there is, of course, rename this. So I'll rename this to users. Even though I named the table users, the page wasn't named users. So I want to make sure that I'm getting that correct. I'm not sure which of these different elements Softr is going to look at. So I want to rename both the tables and the pages, and just to make sure that we're linking up and syncing to the right data. So now we're going to flip into Softr and we're going to create a new thing here. We'll just create something from scratch. So I'll make that selection. And by default, we can select what different pages we want to start with in our new app. A home page, a list details page. And of course, all the user related pages, like how do people sign in? How do they sign up? How do they reclaim their password if they forgot them? How do they look at their profile? All of this stuff. I will toggle off a couple of these, but I'm going to create the base application. Now, of course, every application that you build, whether from scratch or using a template, is going to be similar to this with users logging into the experience, but you'll also have your own unique components that make your app specific for your process and your workflows. So here we go. It's already loaded up. Pretty simple stuff. Couple of high-level things to point out about Softr. Up here we see our headers, and we get at a glance who has access to these headers. This particular header is for logged-in users. This particular header is for the non-logged-in user. So we've got different experiences already built for us here based on who's interacting with the application. Now, the application hasn't even been published yet, but you can see here on our homepage that we got this ability to kind of drill into this data. And we're going to have multiple different pages in any app that we build. We will find those over here on the left. Here are the different pages that we set up by default. The home page, the sign up page, all those member related pages or user related pages. But here's the list page. Now, none of this is actually synced to actual data yet. And that's what we're going to be doing next. So it's time to build that integration. What we're going to do first is actually click on the thing that we want to pull data in from. So in this case, here's our list block that's already here. This was part of the template that we started with when we started building from scratch. You can also add your own list block by simply coming in here saying add block, and then you can choose whether it's a static or a dynamic element that you're bringing in here. So you could bring in a list just like we have already. So again, we're going to select this though, and you can see here it says we don't have a data source yet. So we can select one. This is stuff I've integrated with previously, or we can add another data source. And here you see brand new Notion added to the mix. So now we can build this integration with Notion with just a few clicks. Let's go ahead and continue here. It's going to open up in a new window. And these things are pretty generically similar. You can see it's asking which workspace I want to get synced up to here. And I can see mine here. There is Gareth's workspace. That's the one I was building in on the other page. So that's the one I want to select. And here it's telling us what we are going to give Softr permission to do. View pages, edit pages, create new content, etc. Now it's important to understand that we are saying that we will display the data in our Softr app, but if we give people permission to edit it as well, that will actually override the data that we have on the back end, and it will make whatever changes or edits to the actual data itself. So that's great. Let's select the pages. And here we go. Whew, it's a good thing I listed these out. I've got users, I've got projects. These are the pages that I want to send and integrate with Softr. So let's allow access here. It's authorizing, it's doing its thing, and now we're good. So now it's going to say, well, which of your two databases do you want to pull data into for this particular thing? Now we've got users and we've got projects. I'll show you how to integrate your users in a minute, but right now we're trying to bring data in, so it's going to be the projects. And you can see I'm now integrated with Notion. And if I go over to content, it's going to allow me to bring elements into this. Now, I don't have any cover media, that is images, in Notion. So I'm going to get rid of that. But I do have a tag, and I have a tag called tags. These are the different components that we had inside of Notion. Let's flip really quickly back over to that. What were these called? Properties? Yeah, property. Okay, so we've got name and tags. And that's what we're mapping to right here. So we're bringing in that property of tags and we're going to display it. Now for our heading one, this is going to be the name. And just like that, oh, looks like I misspelled project, but you get the idea. So we're bringing in this information. It is visible in the list block, but this is barely the beginning. We can go deeper. We can say, hey, we're going to do allow edits. We're going to allow you to drill into a particular project, look at the data. We can filter the data so that only people who are assigned to a project can see it or edit it. This is how we can take the data that we have that lives in Notion and really create a custom user experience on the front end where we have permissions, we have edit capabilities, we have delete capabilities, we have filterability around the data. All of that is going to be available once we deploy our upgraded app that we build in Softr thanks to that integration. But we're not done yet. The other part is users. We have to integrate users, not just the data in our app, but also the user information. So again, on the left-hand side, go down to users. Here we are going to sync with the data source, and we're going to select that new data source from Notion that we just integrated with. And wouldn't you know it, we put our user data in the page called users. Now, pro tip, we don't have to bring in all the users. By default, yes, we can do that. Or we can say select users. We can say, hey, we only want to bring in the managers, or we only want to bring in the contractors, or whatever your different rules are. For us, we'll just keep it to all because we don't have a ton. And of course, we have that email field inside of our Notion or property, excuse me. Notion has properties. We have the email property that we've now synced up to. Here's our name property. And if we have an avatar where we're actually storing images of people, and that could be really helpful if people are interacting inside of your app and you want to keep their profile picture or something like that, you can have an avatar. We can also add additional fields like when they were created, when were they last seen, what's the magic link. These are all ways to allow people to get in much more quickly, but we don't need to go into all that. We're just going to save and sync right now. And now we have synced up our users table. In just a moment, you'll see it pull in that information. And there it is. It's now activated. It's been synced. We could tag these user groups by creating the different groups of manager and contractor. And based upon the role that we've selected in Notion, bring that in here. So that's it. We've synced up our users, we created our integration with our data source, now we can publish our app and test it out. We're gonna open it in a new tab. This is the live version of the app, and I can sign in, I can sign up. If we choose to sign in, we could sign in with the email that we provided inside of Notion, which I believe is just my email address. I don't have a password, so we would actually need to go to having trouble here. Fill this out, go through the forgot your password, but you can see all of these different components for our app all came together and we built it from scratch. We didn't even need to start from a template. Once we're all set up here, we can go back to the home page. We can drill into these different components, the different data components. If you want to preview this as you're building, back inside of the builder inside of Softr, you can click on preview. It'll open this up and allow you in here. So that's it. That's how easy it is to build your own app. I'm talking the whole front end experience with permissions, allowing people to edit only what you want them to edit, delete, create. All of this is something that you have full control over when you integrate your Notion backend with your Softr front end. Now for the big question, am I a Notion convert? I don't know about that. I still really love my Airtable and my Smart Suites, but I gotta say, Notion is making improvements. I mean, this is a good-looking software. It obviously has withstood the test of time. Millions and millions of users already here. Maybe it's worth giving a little bit more of a look to. But I will say that my biggest concern, my biggest reason for pause has always been around the fact that Notion doesn't really seem to be as snappy with large data sets. Airtable, Smart Suite, my two preferred tools for the back end, seem to handle large amounts of data much more readily than Notion. But let me know in the comments below if that's not the case. If you have piled a ton of data into Notion and it's handling it like it's no big deal, I'd love to hear about it. I know we went quickly in this video, so if there's something we didn't cover, please swing by our website and ask. Of course, I also want to invite you to join me for some free training. If you are new to no code, I've put together an automation training. It's going to help you streamline your workflows and process. Go ahead and sign up gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Now, like and subscribe if you got value from the video, but most importantly, my friends, keep on building.